In this video, I will be reviewing a chef's knife from Wallop with an AUS8 material. Hello guys, I'm Chef Panko and I work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe if you want to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the review, I want to go over some disclosures. This knife has been sent over by the manufacturer. They are not paying me to make this video or to use the knife, and nobody gets the chance to preview any of this footage before it goes on YouTube. Now with the disclosures away, let's talk about the Wallop AUS8 chef's knife. The Wallop chef's knife has unclaimed imported Japanese AUS8 material. The knife has a thunder-like pattern and there's no cladding on the knife itself. The knife was advertised with a Walker hardness of 58 when I got the knife, but the store changed it to a 56 plus. Since there's no cladding, the complete knife should be an AUS8. An AUS8 is durable and very good against rust resistance. You can compare it to a German steel in terms of sharpness, durability and edge retention. For the full specifications, you can see it in the description below. The knife has a cool looking pattern. However, this is causing some problems with cleaning the blade since there will be food residue on the patterns. The Rockwell hardness was advertised with a 58. They changed that to a 56 plus. But for an imported Japanese AUS8, this is the worst performing AUS8 that I have ever experienced. The knife Rockwell feels more like a 55 or even lower, and that's considered very bad for a Japanese AUS8. The handle is made of a G10 material, which does not require any maintenance. There's also no visible protrusion on the handle. The knife balance point is at the handle, which makes the knife back heavy. The knife weight at 307 grams for an 8.5 inch chef's knife is considered a German knife in terms of weight. The bolster has a flush diagonal cap, which makes it comfortable for the pinch grip at the blade. However, the recommended gripping style is the pinch grip at the handle because of the balance point. To my surprise, this knife has a spine distal taper, which means that the spine thickness at the back is 2.6 mm and slowly goes down to a 0.8 at the tip. This will make the knife the sharpest at the tip, sharp at the front part of the blade and more sturdier at the heel area. The knife has a good finish on the spine and heel, no sharp edges there. The handle is extremely big and it does not feel like I'm holding a knife. It feels more like I'm holding an axe than a kitchen knife. This is basically the most uncomfortable handle that I've ever used. Everything feels unbalanced and uncomfortable despite having a fish belly. The knife is sturdy, but there's a noticeable flex during use. You may or may not like a flex in your chef's knife. The knife has enough knuckle clearance for all gripping styles because of the wide blade profile. However, since the handle is very uncomfortable, all gripping styles will feel horrible. The knife profile is similar to a German chef's knife. For the price point of around $80, this knife is very overpriced. And the reason for that is simple. For an AUS8, this knife is the worst performing AUS8 with an HRC that's around 55 or even lower. Not only is the performance of this Japanese AUS8 on this knife bad, they are also shaming the real Japanese AUS8 by selling this knife, and therefore giving a bad name to the Japanese AUS8 material. Despite having a G10 handle that I like, the design of the handle is very poor. I completely dislike everything about the handle design, since it is way too big to be comfortable for a kitchen knife. It really feels like you are holding a hammer or an axe, than a kitchen knife. The fish belly feels very big and is absolutely not comfortable at all. This knife from Wallop is a knife that will give Chinese knives a bad name. Not only Chinese knives, they are also giving the Japanese AUS8 material a bad name too. Wallop has pretty much checked everything on my list that I was concerned about when I started my journey in buying and testing Chinese made knives with the Japanese core material. If this was my first Chinese made knife purchase, then I would never buy a Chinese made knife again. There is a positive to this knife. Aesthetically, the knife looks amazing, but the blade itself feels cheap. Therefore, I do recommend this knife for people that want to hang this on their wall, just to look at it. I'm honestly very disappointed, even when I got this knife for free. And I would recommend you all to avoid the Wallop AUS8 chef's knife. But if you want it as a decoration, the link to the Wallop store is in the description below. I have more negative things to say, but I think you guys get the point. That's it for this review. If you have any questions, feel free to ask it in the comment section below. And if you disagree with my review or have other opinions, please share them in the comment section so that we can help others in their decision. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video.